use this stove, which is just a single tin can with curtain clips on the bottom, and then a aluminum foil with one piece of steel wire wrapped around it. And then this will go in the center, and this goes on the bottom. So the main part of this is just a can. There's no holes. And the size of the can depends on how big is your water jug. So basically, you can carry it like this. It wouldn't take up any space. And if you have a 1 liter water jug, then what you could do is just get a bigger can. Now, when you use the can opener to remove the top, you have to make sure that you don't leave behind something jagged like this. So that's not good. And the way you do that is when you put the thing on here like this, the handlebar, make sure you turn it opposite way. Turn it this way. So if you turn it this way, then you leave behind this little tag here, which can cut your finger. But if you turn it the opposite way, then it becomes nice and smooth. So at least it wraps around the entire thing, and a bit more, maybe 1.5 times. So the best way to measure that is take your can and make it about 4 to 5 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then you put the foil on a piece of cloth, and then you roll it. So put it on here. And then you roll it like this, and you squeeze it a little bit, okay, scrunch it up, and then roll it a little bit this way. And then when you unroll it, it should look something like this, okay, where it's all scrunched up. And then you use your hand to roll this into a tube. So now it looks like this. Tube. And then on this edge here, you press it down right here. Press it down here. So when you press it down, it curls. So the more you press down, the more it curls. Okay. And then you wrap this around your can. So that's how you form it, like this. And then you can just take a scissor and just cut off the extra pieces that's too long. Now, you only want to insulate the top part where it's burning, but you don't want to insulate the bottom part because you want to keep the fuel cold so it doesn't all burn up at once. You also need some way of cutting the wood. And this is the way I find the best. Take this and then measure so that you cut about half the length, so about this much. So it depends on how long you want to burn for, and usually half was fine, so a piece like that would be perfect. So this is the last piece, and just press it down, and then also press it from the top again, making sure they all stick, so that now it's really, really solid, and the pieces of wood will not fall out. So once the wood is fully assembled and you're ready to use, so you could pre-assemble this if you need it, but when you're ready, then put the clips on the bottom first, and then you put the aluminum foil next, because you wanted this to be thick, so it should be about 1 centimeter thick, and try to avoid making it smaller. If it's, you know, if it flattened it, it doesn't matter, because just unroll this and remake it again. And then after you put this on, and then you tie in place with your wires. So once that's done, pat on top, make sure the aluminum foil is below the rim. Then to light it, I'm going to use birch bark. So I got it from that piece there. There's yeah.你看这树皮很多烟，一点就着，然后这边拔下来的，你看这边一点就着了，什么时候先摆进去？然后呢，我说拿块大木头，压在上面。 Okay, I think that's good enough. And now 25 degree water goes on at this time. So that's 115 grams of wood sticks, which is about maybe about three of those sticks. And then I'm not sure, maybe 20 minutes to boil 1 liter of water.